Thank you, guys. And oh, we were so close to bonus games.
It was
a great fight by HQ, but I do want to jump directly into our replay. It is this final fight. And Spawn, I'm throwing it to you because I think it's worthwhile to look at how SKT took advantage of their man advantage on the map.
Yeah, and exactly how they got there. So if we pull it up, SKT, as soon as you make that first mistake, are going to jump on top of it. And exactly that happened. Albus went into the red buff, tried to get some vision for himself, and was completely deleted off the map.
So if let's pull that up, please.
Yeah, so if we grab the replay. So the whole lead up to this, the other frustrating thing about this game for Westory, he is so fed. He's a 6-item, 6-stack, level 18 Cho'Gath. He's like, if I am actually allowed into the fight, I will delete anyone. And you see, he tries to get Wolf there. Instead, the rest of his team gets him. They really commit to it and keep him in the middle of the team fight. And right here, if we freeze it out, you look at how much they're willing to spend just killing Westor. At the end of the day, that is 4 members taking out the biggest threat on their team and only mine taking everyone up. So if we keep rolling this one out, you see the rest of AHQ trying to take down mine. He's that tanky, and from here, Easy Hoon just cleans up.
Oh yeah, it's a beautiful wall too here that we're about to see by Easy Hoon pushing the last couple members back into the team.
Easy Hoon just overall having an amazing performance, I think, on this LZR.
He got him during a tunnel too.
Yeah, heartbreaking. And to be honest, you know, it is a heartbreaking way to lose that game there for HQ, having been in such great position and picking some pretty stellar fights.
What was Alpha doing?
To be caught out exactly and create that 4v5 to begin with.
You know, going into the game, we thought it could be a close game just from the way that AHQ had been playing. And it was for the very beginning. It was very close. And then AHQ started building on a gold lead. But I think they just got a little bit too antsy and didn't really focus as to what their team composition needs to do versus a heavy wave clear such as Azir. The fourth dragon, when they got a nice kill in the mid lane, instead of prioritizing the turrets, you kill Azir, that's the go. You need to go for a tower now because it's the only chance you're going to go for that. They choose to go for a dragon and then another in near tower, I think, like, you can't do that versus a high wave clear composition. Also, when you have such a good lead, their ward control, the vision denial that they had, was not good at all. If you don't have pink wards, if you don't have your sweepers being used effectively, the enemy is going to see all your rotations, making it that much harder to get wave clear. You need to be looking for the places that Azir is not it. The only wave clear is Azir. Just go to the lane that where he's not, and you can get a tower. But without the vision denial, you're not going to get it done.
I think that in this point, the wave clear was relatively important, but I think AHQ played the map actually really well. They had a high tempo, and that actually was see in the bot lane tower dives, which were really, really strong, where the jungler just couldn't keep up, and they executed so crisp. And what that leads to is both teams have those really crisp executions from their strategic play. So what you see on the map is they get a kill on the one side for SKT, and on the other side you see EDG pick up a kill. And that is just both teams, instead of trying to go back and defend, both go aggressive and get the kills.
We'll go back into the early game play from AHQ. We do have an interview ready before we look at the semifinals. Let's set up the stage for it. We're going to send it over to Shox, who's joined by one of SKT's winning players.
Thanks so much, Dash. I'm joined here by Marin after that victory by SKT and locking in the first place going into the playoffs. Yet AHQ put up quite a fight. What do you think happened that it turned out to be a pretty close game, Marin?
그 HQ랑 되게 그 치열한 경기를 했어요. 어떻게 된 건가요?
그냥 제가 초반에 좀 많이 못해서 경기가 길게 이어졌던 것 같고 그래도 이제 후반에 팀원적으로 팀워크가 맞아서 이제 한타 쉽게 쉽게 해서 이겼던 것 같아요.
I think I made a lot of mistakes during the early game, but during the mid and late game, our teamwork got better and our team started to work together and we managed to pull off a victory.
Absolutely did. It was also quite a close game versus Fnatic before, and you'll be facing them in the semifinals tomorrow. Huni said that he's confident that they might be able to take it. What are you feeling about that matchup?
그 오늘 Fnatic과의 경기도 되게 이제 좀 힘든 경기를 하셨는데 내일 4강전에서 다시 붙게 됩니다. 그 아까 후니 선수가 인터뷰 때 다시 붙게 되면 이길 자신 있다고 말씀하셨는데 그거에 대해 어떻게 생각하시나요?
저도 후니 선수랑 해서 좀 안 좋은 결과를 만들어서 이제 다시 만나면 이제 이겨줄 생각하고 있었는데 예, 왠지 제가 이길 것 같습니다.
I also had an unsatisfying match against Huni during earlier today, so I'm ready for the rematch, and I think I can beat him next time.
Think you can beat him? If you do manage to beat him, that means you guys would make it to the final versus EDG of AHQ. After seeing all those teams play and having played against them, who do you think might make it out of semifinals of those two?
마리 선수가 말씀하신 대로 이제 훈이 선수를 이기면 결승전에 올라갈 텐데요. 결승전에는 이제 HQ와 EDG 승자 올라갈 텐데 오늘 경기를 다 보시면 좀 누가 올라올 것 같나요? 결승전에.
이제 코로 선수가 올라올 것 같은데 네, 일단 코로 선수가 올라올 것 같습니다.
I think Koro and his team EDG will come to the finals.
All right, then I do want to follow up because we talked to Koro beforehand and he said, well, I think I can beat Marin. What do you feel about that matchup specifically versus Koro?
그럼 코로 선수는 이제 만약 다시 본다면 마린 선수를 이길 수 있다고 본인이 더 나은 선수라고 인 것을 증명했다고 말씀하는데 그거에 대해 어떻게 생각하시나요?
일단 코로 선수도 잘하는 선수인데 저보다 나은 선수일 것 같지는 않고요. 그리고 네, 일단 경기로 한번 보여드리도록 하겠습니다.
I admit Koro is a good player, but I don't think he's a better player than I am. I'll just show you my results in the actual game.
All right, well, if it comes to that, we will see. Congratulations in any case. Dominating performance here by SKT in the group stage. Dash, back over to you.
Thank you, Shock. Some looking forward there with Marin. We'll do that in a second. I want to take another look again at that early game. Spawn, to you, the pressure that AHQ applied to get that lead.
Yeah, it was just amazing. In the end, it was all came down to their jungler again. He came bottom once from the behind the turret, gave up first blood, but blew all the summoner spells. From there, you'd be like, all right, guys, I did my job. Summoner spell's gone. Shove in the lane, harass them, try and win out on CS. But instead, comes back a second time, really punishes them, capitalizes on all his earlier work. From there, they continue aggression. Marn comes in this time. They lose again, and you're like, okay, maybe this is getting out of hand. We should change our focus. To hell with that, they go for a fourth attempt down there. They even bring their teleport in. And in the end, they just ran over the bottom lane. They got their carry, their primary carry, that Sivir player, and into a really good position to do work.
Man, yeah. I was so excited about this game, watching it all the time, because there was so much aggression. And it was not uncontrolled, where you sometimes think, ah, oh, you know, what is he doing there? And there's a fight erupting there. This was really controlled, and that was really, really nice to see.
Yeah, I think in this tournament, it's going to sound a little bit like a broken record. The TPs from top laners are extremely important, and tower dive execution with junglers early game, because the people who cannot execute on those two things have already fallen by the wayside, and we're seeing that more and more.
With
and
Rek'Sai's early game.
That's the thing, yeah. Is Rek'Sai's so good at turret dives, because you use your gap closer, you don't have to use your flash like a Gragas E flash in, and you get to just unburrow on top of them, walk up. The turret aggro and jumping is very easy, because then you just come back out after flashing. It's really easy.
What I want to see from AHQ moving forward into the quarterfinal or semifinals is going to be utilizing the flanking maneuvers from the double Righteous Glory, from the global of Rek'Sai, from the flashes in Maokai versus an immobile champion like Azir. The second you get on him, he's dead. So we always saw some sort of line engages versus a team, and that's just not going to cut it versus an Azir where he can just set up the Emperor's Divide and really zone you off. Better vision denial, a little bit of better vision control, and now you get your Maokai teleporting behind the Azir. Couple it with the Nautilus Assault, he dies instantly. We saw none of that. If they apply that technique to their matches moving forward, I think we might have a contender.
But honestly, I feel like AHQ did a really good job against SKT and caught them sometimes.
Oh, of course.
With their pants down, SKT was like, we start a fight here. And then CV was coming in. They bait in the fight in the top side, Tribush, for example, in the late 20, 30 minutes. And SKT is overchasing, thinking they have an opportunity. CV is going in from the mid lane. TP getting the kills, and Easyhoon with a huge play actually evening it out for a 1v1, I think, is like, Aussie player.
You can't be satisfied with what you got here. You need to go for more.
We want more.
Easyhoon, though, watching him play is just always a big treat. He died 2 times again. That's it. Like, he has only had 1 game this entire year where he's died more than 2 times. This guy just doesn't go down, and he does so much damage while he's doing it. He did 50,000 damage this game. The next highest was Ann, the very fed Sivir, doing 29,000.
Oh, well, spawn last year.
Much higher.
Yeah, the scariest thing about this game for me is that even when you play tempo against SKT, you make one mistake and they beat you. Yeah. Every single game they win, it's just one mistake. They snowball it, take everything off the map, crush you. So that is the scariest thing if you are going to play tempo against them.
All right, well, with the group stages officially in the books, let's see how the standings shook out. With that amazing win there, SKT remains undefeated at 5-0 and heads into the semifinals as the number one seed. Edward Gaming and AHQ Esports Club are tied at 4-1, but with EDG owning the head-to-head over AHQ, that gives them the number two seed and AHQ takes third. And finally, at 2-3, we have Fnatic with the number four seed and the final spot in tomorrow's bracket stage. That means we have our semifinal bracket filled in, and the stage is set for tomorrow's best of fives. First up is Korea's SK Telecom T1 versus Europe's Fnatic, and that will be followed by China's Edward Gaming versus the LMS's AHQ Esports. So now as we look ahead to those matches, gentlemen, we've seen all of these teams in close contention. When we look first at that Fnatic versus SK match, this is one of the teams that made them bleed.
I think Fnatic is really hungry for this rematch, and I think if they don't have any kind of mental blockhead, which they shouldn't have after this strong performance, they can pull an upset. I'm very sure. But again, SKT, I feel all the Koreans team are like brick walls. You just bash your head and you see it crack sometimes and crumble, but in the end, you just fall flat.
We heard Marin in the interview saying that he didn't feel very good about his matchup against Huni. So, you know, again, when you know, he's the big carry for Fnatic.
Huni.
Will he be able to shore up, you know, his laning phase against Huni?
I think he's got a good chance of doing that, especially since Huni really just threw him for a loop. It's one of those things where if Huni leaves lane, now you're going to be able to know his tendencies, be like, okay, he might be heading mid, inform Faker or Easy Hoon, which is going to be that extra strategy that they have in those best of fives, subbing somebody out. So like they now know his tendency to want to roam and snowball the game. So after playing against Huni, I don't think it's going to be as surprising.
Now let's look at the second match, Crumbs, AHQ versus EDG. EDG got the better of them last time, but AHQ again has shown us that they can really dance with these top teams.
Again, we expected them to just get better as the tournament progressed, and they have done exactly that, but there's still flaws in their closing out the game. I really want to see them learn from this. It's not the hardest thing to adapt, being able to just place a little bit more wards, buy some more pink wards. But the other thing I don't like about it is the fact that they are still very one-dimensional, just focus the bottom lane over and over and over. I mean, they had one or two ganks in the top side, which is similar to almost all the games they played. They're gonna have to switch it up because that is a very exploitable thing. If the jungler chooses to take a route to counter the bottom lane dives nonstop, it's gonna get punished very hard.
Yeah, I'm actually looking for EDG to revert to how they played against LGD and just throw this late. I think that they will actually take the Rek'Sai off the board, try and force Mountain onto Jarvan, and then just stall this one out and trust that they can carry the game late. Because if they go fire with fire, I'm actually revising my opinion on how AHQ are playing. I don't think that they have enough fear to actually fail with that game sense, because I thought after two failed attempts of the gank bottom that they would give up on it, but they just kept going. So this team, they like just beat you with a club.
They don't see it as a failure. They're like, okay, we got a flash. It'll work next time.
Well,
it's
a challenge. Doing it, right? They also see it as having the teleport advantage and really like, okay, well, we have TP. We got to do something. You got to be proactive when you face a team like SKT or EDG, and I like that about them. They're not scared.
I think that's a big thing in this tournament. The proactive team seems to be the one coming out on top, even if they're against a team where it's like the odds are stacked against them. When AHQ is being proactive, they put SK Telecom playing their game, and that's a problem for them. So I think the proactive teams in this tournament
I'm calling it today. I think that EDG and AHQ, we will see a lot of tower dives. We see successful ones, but I think also failed ones, and that will actually be a huge
problem. I think the last point as well is that EDG have to shore up their pick ban phase. We questioned it against SKT. AHQ's pick ban phase has actually looked really stellar. They have a lot of synergy in their comp, and I like the Cho'Gath pick up there. So I think that they really have the advantage in that edge.
Well, the stage is set for some pretty stellar semifinals tomorrow. Now, if you aren't able to make it to Tallahassee but still want to watch the MSI finals with fellow esports fans, Coca-Cola and Cinemark Theaters are hosting viewing parties across the United States to bring the exciting conclusion of this tournament to the big screen. For more information on the 15 theaters where you can catch the show on Sunday, May 10th, and get yourself a collectible Heimerdinger Cup, head over to lolesports.com/VP. And that does it for the group stage here in Florida. On behalf of myself, the analyst desk, and the entire broadcast team, thank you for joining us on day two of the 2015 Midseason Invitational, and we'll see you right back here on Saturday for the semifinals.
I think EDG, if they bring their A game this time around versus Fnatic, I think EDG will come out on top.
doesn't even give the assist to Defens Rainover. He's going to try and tunnel out. Coro with the twisted advance. Booty just getting destroyed.
Holy shit. Oh, look at this.
Why do you
that so pinky. That was a disgusting performance from the Chinese. Flash is on beautiful arcane smash.
The most hilarious sequence of events.
Able to get the exhaust off, but Death being the hero. Blackness over the arc to get off. Triple kill. Theocles comes back alive. They get the rest of the job done.
That was a fantastic ultimate from Uni. Wow, and what a route. Fnatic secures themselves in the playoffs.
Phase and it gets shut down. Headshot.